Welcome back. Today we are going to start our new chapter, Wave Motion. So, let's start the chapter. Here you can see a boy. After placing a paper boat in the pond, the boy is continuously making ripples in the water to push it away from the shore. But the boat moves only up and down and it doesn't move forward. Can you say what may be the reason? And here also you can see a trough with water to about half of its capacity. So put some thermocol balls in it. With your finger, make ripples on the surface of the water. At that time, we can see the disturbance spreading from its origin to other places. That is, it spread like expanding concentric circle. So, this type of disturbance spreading from its origin to other places is wave motion. Water particles move up and down about their mean position but without any displacement in the direction of propagation of the wave. Wave motion is one of the means to transfer energy from one region of the medium to another. In a wave motion, the energy received by one particle is transferred from particle to particle, thus spreading all over. That is, wave motion is the propagation of disturbances produced in one part of a medium to the other parts by the vibration of its particles. Some examples of wave motion are waves formed on water surface, radio waves, light waves, sound waves, etc. Can you say, do all these waves need a medium for their propagation? Waves formed on water surface, sound waves, etc. needs a medium for their propagation. Radio waves and light waves needs no medium for their propagation. They can propagate without a medium. The waves which need a medium for their propagation are mechanical waves. So, there are mainly two types of mechanical waves, transverse waves and longitudinal waves. First, we are going to learn about transverse waves. Students, let's imagine a rope. One end of the rope is tied to a window. And you can see the particles of the rope. So here rope is the medium. Here all the particles in the medium are at rest when the wave is not formed. Here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J and K are the particles in the medium rope. Let's consider the particles A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K in the medium. When transverse waves are formed, all the particles began to vibrate. Here, all particles move up and down from its position. From this, we can see the particles which vibrates in a similar manner. For example, A, E, I moves up and down in same way. Like this, we can see so many particles which moves similar. The distance advanced by the wave, by the time a particle completes one vibration, that is from A to E, is the wavelength. Like this, we can consider the length from J to K also. The wavelength of J to K is same as that of from A to E. A transverse wave is a wave in which the particles of the medium vibrate in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. So what is a transverse wave? It is the wave in which the particles of the medium vibrate in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. So let's see the characteristics of waves. First one, amplitude. Amplitude is the maximum displacement of a particle from its mean position. This is denoted by the letter small letter A, and here 2.5 cm is the amplitude of this wave. Next one, wavelength. Wavelength is the distance advanced by the wave by the time a particle completes one vibration. This is equivalent to the distance between two consecutive particles which are in the same phase of vibration. The Greek letter lambda is used to denote wavelength. Its unit is meter. Next one, period. Period of a wave is the time taken for a particle in a medium to make one complete vibration. This is represented by the letter capital T. The unit of period is second. Next one, frequency. Frequency is the number of vibrations in 1 second. That is, frequency equals number of vibrations by time taken. If frequency and period are interrelated, we can write it down as F equals 1 by T. The unit of frequency is hertz, represented by H Z. Next one, speed of a wave. The speed of a wave is the distance traveled by the wave in 1 second. Speed equals distance traveled by time. Wavelength is the distance traveled by a wave in a time of 1 period. So, speed of a wave equals lambda by T. That is, V equals 1 by T into lambda. Therefore, V equals F into lambda. That is, speed or velocity of a wave equals F into lambda. Next one, longitudinal waves. For that, here you can see a tuning fork. So, let's see the vibration of a tuning fork when it hits with a hammer. The sound waves reach our ears when the tuning fork is vibrated with a hammer. The vibrations of the tuning fork make the air particles around it to vibrate. So, due to that, high pressure is experienced in places where the air particles are close to each other. Such regions are the compressions, represented by capital C. And some low pressure regions are also formed. The regions of low pressure are the rarefactions, denoted by capital R. Let's see the definition for longitudinal wave. A longitudinal wave is a wave in which the particles of the medium vibrate in a direction parallel to the direction of propagation of the wave. This creates compressions, that is C, and rarefactions, that is capital R, alternately in the medium. So, the differences between transverse waves and longitudinal waves are: transverse waves vibrate in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave, while longitudinal waves vibrate in a direction parallel to the direction of propagation of the wave. In transverse waves, crests and troughs are formed, but in longitudinal waves, compressions and rarefactions are formed. So, let's see how we can determine the wavelength of longitudinal wave. The distance between corresponding points of two consecutive compressions or two consecutive rarefactions is the wavelength of the longitudinal wave. So, students, that's for today. Thank you for watching.